Guys, I finally got my iPad Pro 2021, this bad boy right here, and I've been painting on it using the Procreate app, and the performance is outstanding. The colors are, oh my god, so good. I really enjoyed the experience overall, but I didn't like one part. So when I had my old iPad, I had a screen protector on it, which gave me the resistance that I needed, and it was just so lovely to work with. But then on this one, I had to work on the screen itself, and I don't know, some people love it, but for me it was just like slippery. I didn't like the noise, the sound that it made. It's just, you know, not my thing. I need a little bit of resistance while I'm painting, and so I decided I need a screen protector. And so, like probably most of you, I've seen so many digital art YouTubers talk about the Paperlike screen protector. So I thought, okay, you know what? It's finally time to give it a shot. So I reached out to them and asked if they would want to send me one and I would review it. They said yes, and just so we're clear, they didn't pay me to say anything. All of this review is my own entirely, and to be fair, I did come with a little bit of reservations about this screen protector, because even though like 90% of the reviews were positive, there were still a few videos where people didn't necessarily love it. And most of these people weren't digital artists. They were other sorts of artists like photographers and musicians and all that stuff. But still, like, even though a small part of people didn't like it as much, I wanted to test it for myself. And so there were a few things that those people didn't like that they mentioned, and one of them being that the colors look way dimmer. There's not enough vibrancy or contrast once you put on the screen protector. So I'm going to be paying attention to that, as well as that it is hard to draw using it because it's too much resistance, that it scratches easily, it leaves scratches on the screen protector itself. Ow, yikes, I hope that one's not true. And then finally, that the pen nib of the actual Apple Pencil wears off so quickly. Again, hope that's not true. We'll test soon, because I gave it a whole week before recording this video, so let's see. First of all, I recorded a little clip showing what the actual colors, what some of my old paintings look like without the screen protector on. And then once I applied it, I recorded another video showing the same colors, so we can see side by side whether or not the colors have changed, the contrast dimmed, whatever the accusations were. And guys, I messed up a little bit, because if you look at the two side by side, you can see that, wow, the colors have really dimmed, you know, like it's not the same. But pay attention to the table. And if you do, you will see that one table is significantly darker than the other one, which means that the screen is also shown differently on camera. And that's because I recorded them at two different times of the day, and so the light from the window wasn't hitting the same way. The brightness of the iPad was also different. I know, I messed up. I'm sorry. So this experiment sort of failed, but to my eyes, all I can say is that it looks like it is a little bit dimmer, which totally makes sense, right? You're putting something on top of the screen, but it wasn't such a significant difference that it would make me go, wow, I need to take it off immediately, you know? So I guess I'm just, I messed up. I wanted it to be like a cool comparison, but it didn't work. My apologies. But again, if you trust my eyes, it looks okay to me, like it doesn't bother me. But that doesn't mean the other things aren't true, so let's keep going. So, applying the Paperlike protector. Okay, so yes, I have been living under a rock. That's a disclaimer right there, because I've never applied a screen protector before in my life. Yes, sadly, it's true. But with the screen protector, once I opened it, it has all these cool things inside. And it has this little art, also like a card, but it's an artist's art. And I thought that was beautiful. I'm just gonna keep it on my table now forever, because I love how it turned out. And it also gives you two screen protectors and also all the things you need to apply them, like the stickers and the wiping cloth and the other things. Like basically, you have everything you need for the two applications, which is lovely. And then instead of printing instructions, they give you this little card that says basically watch this video. love it as well. As a visual person, I'd much rather see a video of somebody do it so I can follow along, because again, never done it before, freaking out at this point. So I watched the video 2 times. The person who did it was so crafty. They did it so quickly. It looked super easy, but you can't fool me, right? Because I know that if somebody is doing something a lot, it looks like it's easy to do. But then when you try to do it, who's never done it, it's not so easy. The same applies to art or any sort of sports, basically anything. If it looks too easy, just know that it's not. The person is just a genius. So I tried applying it, excuse my head popping up in the screen. I just tried to record it and try to make sure it's perfect. Spoiler alert, it is not perfect. One of the sides has more space than the other. Doesn't bother me, I'm fine with that. Still pretty proud that I managed to do it anyway. So if you are like me, and there's no worse than that, you can apply the Paperlike protector too. Don't worry about it, it's gonna work out. After the application, what I noticed right away is that there is a certain grain to it, which I have a love-hate relationship with. And actually the same was with the other screen protectors, so it's not really a new thing. And that's what gives you that extra resistance. It's the lovely texture, all that stuff. But as somebody who loves adding grain at the end of my painting process, it confuses me, because on one hand, I love it because it gives me that feeling of texture. And it just makes my experience of drawing so, so much more pleasant. That is just wonderful. But on the other side, I completely forget that I didn't add grain and it's just the beautiful texture of the screen protector. So I forget to add it, then I export it to my phone, then I'm like, oh, wait a minute, where's the grain, you know? So that's annoying, but the experience that it gives, I think it's worth it. So I think the colors are not very dimmed by the screen protector. They are slightly dimmed, and yes, there is grain. So if you are editing video or maybe photos and you want to see the super crisp details, you don't want any grain at all because you to yourself think that it's noise from the camera, then I see how that could come in unknowingly. But that's a payoff that you get from the texture. And also, like, I don't know, I just love grain. I want everything to be grainy in my life. So, I don't know, I guess this is just a personal preference at this point. And now I don't have to hit the screen with my pencil and hear that noise of plastic touching the screen, and it's just, ew, like, ugh. Now it's like much more pleasant, which, by the way, listen to this sound. I specifically took my microphone and lowered it lower so you can hear it, so listen. Isn't that beautiful? Although maybe on the video it doesn't sound too beautiful, I don't know, that's for you to judge. In real life, it gives me the pleasant, warm feeling that I am using something more traditional, which again comes in handy with the whole paper-like thing, because it's paper-like, you know what I mean? So yeah, as somebody coming from traditional background, love it. And so to the other note that people had, their reservation that it is harder to draw using the Paperlike screen protector because you have to press so much harder because it adds that extra resistance. That is correct. I agree with that accusation of sorts, but also, like, isn't that the reason why you got a screen protector in the first place? Like, for the artist, right? Not like to, oh, I'm afraid to crack my screen. It's more like I need that resistance. So some people say it's too much of resistance. So anyway, I did find that it was harder to draw. However, as somebody who knows Procreate, like my 5 fingers, I mean 10, I know that if you go to the settings, preferences, edit pressure curve, it is going to be so, so much easier to draw when you adjust that curve. You can play around with it. You can make it even harder to draw, which is like impossible to make any strokes at all. Or you can make it super easy and then you have to press super lightly. So if I go down, I have to press even harder. It's almost impossible to get the black lines to work. And if I go all the way up, it's always going to be the darkest. I can't make any light strokes. So I have to find... Yep, that's about perfect for me.
this is how I work, but depending on the way you put your pencil and your strokes down, yours might look a little bit different.
And I adjusted it to the way that is perfect for me, for my hand, for how I like working. And you can do the same if you're using Procreate. If you use any other software, I can almost guarantee almost all of them have something similar to the pressure curve. So you should do a little quick Google search and find out what it's called like in your software, how to access it, and then play with it, adjust it, and then you have no issues at all. Now that I made sure that it is perfect for my hand and how I like to use it, I made this quick sketch just to get used to the way it feels to paint with this screen protector on. The sound it makes is much better than the sound without the screen protector, and the overall experience for myself was just slightly more inspiring to work with, and so that was enjoyable. But will it withhold the ultimate test, the test of time? And that is something I decided to discover throughout the week as I was working on these paintings. So I did 3 more paintings in the span of the time. One of them is cute red hair girl that I found on the sketchy app. But anyway, I found this, thought it was inspiring, so I did the painting, and that was fun. I had a lot of great time just working through it, and just the experience was overall really pleasant. I mean, it's kind of hard to talk about how screen protector affects your workflow, but just because it has that extra texture, extra resistance, I don't know, for me, it is more enjoyable. And then I also did a quick study of a still from the Forbidden Kingdom, also had a blast. And finally, one of those days, I wasn't really in the mood, so I kind of painted from imagination, which is great, right? You need to explore all sides of creativity. You need to grow all of your skills in different areas. So I did a little painting of a girl who was not in the mood, just like I was. So I can't tell you that that experience was exactly pleasant because of the mood that I was in, but I didn't think about the screen protector at all, whether it was or wasn't there. I was just already so used to feeling like this is how it's supposed to be, and I was urging for that feeling. Remember I told you how I had a screen protector? Well, this one has more resistance and more texture than the other one that I bought on Amazon, and so yeah, I just loved it. You know, I stopped even thinking about the fact that I'm recording a video. So I even forgot to record some of these processes. So thank God Procreate has the video recording of your process thing, or otherwise this video would have been boring without any process whatsoever. I just had fun. And ultimately, isn't that what you want out of all of your supplies? Whether that's your iPad or pencil or screen protector, you just want to have fun, right? So I did. And that is a success, I think. I also like to journal on my iPad, so when it came time to writing with a pencil on the Paperlike, that is where it truly shined. So after the week, I decided to check, were there any scratches? And unfortunately, I did discover that there are minor scratches on the Paperlike screen protector. Here, I'm going to try to record a video for you to show it to you from different angles. But like, while I'm looking at the iPad from the viewpoint that I'm looking at it when I'm working or drawing or writing, I don't really see those scratches. I have to really put it to the light to notice them. But they are there. So that accusation was correct. There are some of the scratches. And if that's something that bothers you a lot, maybe this is not the right product for you. For me, maybe I'm just like so easygoing, and I'm pretty easy to satisfy, to be honest. And like, it doesn't bother me, you know? And as for the nib of the Apple Pencil, I didn't notice any difference whatsoever. But again, it was only a week, so maybe it takes time. But don't they wear off anyway? Like, I assume they wear off with time, whether or not you're using a screen protector. Because of their resistance, I can see how it could probably wear off faster. But that's like, just logically speaking, that's what makes sense. And that's basically all I have to say about the Paperlike screen protector. If there will be any updates, like in a month, 2 or 3, where I'm like, I hate this, this is horrible, then I'm going to include it in the comment section and I'm gonna pin that comment. So if it's there, change my mind. If it's not there, still the same thoughts, you know? But so far, love it. Can't wait to work with it more. Do I think you should get it? If you want to. Like, if you want the resistance, if you want the texture, if you feel like you hate the slippery screen, get it. All that matters is that you have a wonderful time creating work without thinking about the technical stuff, without thinking the pencil, the iPad. You just have to think about your work. Whatever helps you get there, you need it. And if you also have the screen protector and you have any of these issues, you have some other new issues, or you absolutely have no issues and love it like I do, leave a comment down below and let me know, because I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to hear from your experience, how it kind of works for you. Did you have any issues after a few months? Like, do you still love it? Let me know. Can't wait to hear from you. And if you have the time, watch one of these next. Stay creative, keep creating, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and bye.